Hello, I'm Rob Pratt, a senior R&D manager at SAS. In this video, I'll show you how to use PROC OPTMODEL to solve optimization problems with hybrid approaches. PROC OPTMODEL contains an algebraic modeling language that enables you to define optimization problems by declaring decision variables, constraints, bounds, and objectives algebraically. It also supports numeric or character parameters, arrays, and index sets. As a SAS procedure, OPTMODEL is closely integrated with the SAS programming environment. You can read and write as many data sets as you want. As with any modeling language, it supports separation between model and data so that you can solve other instances just by changing the data and not changing the model. PROC OPTMODEL is interactive and provides direct access to the linear, mixed integer linear, quadratic, nonlinear, constraint programming, and network solvers. As I'll illustrate, you can write customized algorithms. PROC OPTMODEL includes almost all of the standard SAS functions, and you can also write your own functions by using PROC FCMP. For simple enough optimization problems, you can formulate a model, call the appropriate solver, and report the resulting solution. But for some problems, the best approach is to combine the strengths of several solvers by writing a customized algorithm that invokes these solvers as subroutines. The first example is the p-median problem, which is a type of facility location problem that I'll describe in more detail in later slides. It uses both the mixed integer linear and linear programming solvers. The second example is a political districting problem that uses MILP, constraint programming, and two algorithms from the network solver, connected components and shortest path. The third example is an oil well scheduling and routing problem that uses the MILP and network solvers, again to compute connected components, but also to solve several traveling salesman problems that arise. The p-median problem is a variant of the uncapacitated facility location problem. The inputs are the customer locations, weights, which might represent importance or amount of demand, and a positive integer p. The problem is to select exactly p of the customer locations to build facilities, and the objective is to minimize the total weighted distance from each customer to that customer's closest facility. This plot shows the customer locations for 200 customers. If p equals 5 and all weights are 1, the resulting optimal solution looks like this, with 5 locations selected as facilities. Each edge joins a customer to the closest facility. Here's the first snippet of PROC OPTMODEL code. The first var statement declares a binary decision variable, build j, that indicates whether to build a facility at site j. The second var statement declares a non-negative decision variable, assign ij, that represents the proportion of customer i's demand to assign to a facility at site j. The min statement declares the objective to minimize total weighted distance, which is a linear function of the assigned variables. The first con statement declares a cardinality constraint that forces exactly p facilities to be built. The assign once constraint assigns each customer to exactly one site. And the final constraint uses a linear inequality to enforce the logical implication that if a customer I is assigned to site J, then a facility must be built at J. The solve statement then invokes the MILP solver. This direct approach to solve the problem can require a large amount of memory and computational time for a large number of customers. Next, I'll describe an indirect approach that uses an optimization method called Bender's decomposition. This method applies to problems for which fixing a set of complicating variables makes the resulting problem easy. In the original paper by Bender's in 1962, in which he considered MILP problems, he recommended taking the integer variables as complicating because fixing all the integer variables leaves a linear programming problem over the remaining continuous variables. And this LP is much easier than the original MILP. Bender's decomposition involves a MILP master problem that recommends values for the complicating variables, and an LP subproblem that generates optimality and feasibility cuts for the master problem. The algorithm iterates between master and subproblem until the optimality gap is small enough. Bender's decomposition is a dual of Danzig-Wolf decomposition, which involves complicating constraints rather than complicating variables. The PROC OPTMODEL code shown here defines the MILP master problem. There's a new non-negative variable called eta, and the objective is to minimize eta. For the p-medium problem, the subproblem is always feasible, so the master problem does not include any feasibility cuts. But it does include optimality cuts, which are generated dynamically. Initially, the numeric parameter numOptCuts is 0, and so the set OptCuts is empty. The optimality cut constraints are declared only once and are automatically updated when numOptCuts changes. The problem statement declares a problem called master that contains the build variables and cardinality constraint declared earlier, as well as the eta variable, master objective, and optimality cuts declared in this slide. The LP subproblem is even simpler. It is the same as the original MILP, except that the complicating build variables are fixed. The problem statement declares a problem called subproblem that includes everything from the original problem except the build variables and the cardinality constraint that involves only the build variables. This do until loop is the heart of the Bender's decomposition implementation. The use problem statement in line 2 switches focus to the master problem, and the solve statement in line 3 invokes the MILP solver. Lines 4 through 7 record some information about the resulting solution. The use problem statement in line 8 switches focus to the subproblem, and the solve statement in line 9 invokes the LP solver. If the resulting feasible solution is better than the incumbent solution, the best upper bound and incumbent are updated. If the master objective has underestimated the true objective, the subproblem dual values are used to generate a new optimality cut for the master. This back and forth between MILP master and LP subproblem continues until the optimality gap between lower and upper bound decreases to some user-specified threshold. Although this approach is more complicated than just calling the MILP solver once, Bender's decomposition exploits problem structure and can reduce the amount of memory needed to solve large problems. For more details, including all of the code needed to solve another facility location variant, see the SAS Global Forum 2011 paper listed here. The other two papers cover the political districting problem and oil well scheduling and routing problem mentioned earlier. All three examples illustrate the use of multiple solvers within one PROC OPTMODEL session to implement a customized algorithm. This concludes the video. I hope you find these examples useful when you encounter difficult optimization problems. For more information, please visit support.sas.com.